My name is Sandra Smith. I'm 50 years of age. I live in Dania Beach. I'm an immigrant. I was born in Georgetown, Guyana. I came to America to my husband in 2005. Oh, when I first came here, I went to school to do like nurse's assistant. So I used to do a lot of living jobs. And then after then, I got tired of the living jobs. And I realized that sometimes I'm not cut out for, you know, people yelling and screaming. And so I decided to change my profession and I started doing security. So I used to do security jobs. I work at hotels. I was a dispatcher at Hilton Hotel. I quit that and I used to work at the American Airlines Arena as an event staff. At the same time, I used to be working with the Miami Dolphins as a cook. I'm a mother of 5 kids. 4 boys, 1 girl. I have 8 grandkids. My oldest son is married. It's very hard sometimes when I talk about it and it makes me get so emotional because, you know, I have my kids in my country. So, you know, sometimes it's very hard when you're living in one country and you have your kids in another country with the wages that you're making. You can't get on a flight like every year to say you're going to visit them. You have to be saving money for a while to go see them. I don't even know my grandkids. They're in Guyana. Oh, I went into the military after I had my first child. So I was about like 21 years of age. And I spent 19 years into the military. Yes. It was really great because, you know, I had fun. You know, I see some places, you know, and it was really nice in the military. I was a musician over there. I used to was a steel orchestra player. I was really good. I don't be ashamed to tell my story. It was a blessing when I got this apartment because before I couldn't afford an apartment. Honestly, my clothes was in the storage. I used to be sleeping in the airport. I used to sleep at this friend house, that friend house. You know, sometimes I never used to want nobody to get fed up of me. So I used to put my stuff in my backpack and I would sleep in the airport. None of my co-workers, they never know. And I have everything in my bag, my cologne, so nobody could never tell that I used to be sleeping in the airport. I lived like that actually for 2 years. I never wanted to go where my daughter was living because our upbringing is a very different upbringing to Americans' upbringing or other countries. We don't really like depend on our kids. We tell ourselves that, you know, kids don't owe us anything for bringing them into the world. You understand? And as a parent, you're obligated to help your kids even though when they're older and they look forward to you for support, you're supposed to be there for them. Around like July in 2015, and I went to my daughter's house, and when I got there, I sat down and I was talking to her, and then I was panting for breath. I couldn't breathe. So our boyfriend was home at the time, and I told him to take me to the closest hospital because I feel like my life was snapping out of leaving my body. The nurse did the vital signs, everything, and she told me to sit down and wait. She put me into a room and tell me she's gonna be right back. But before she stepped out, I feel so drained and I stand up. I stand up and I held on to her hand and I didn't know anything else till 7 days after when I opened my eyes and see tube in my nose, tube in my mouth, tubes all over. I had to go return back out to work like 4 days after the doctors didn't give me a lot of time. So I had to go back to work. The neighborhood, people used to say it's a ghetto neighborhood, but I've never found it to be a ghetto neighborhood because nobody's car hasn't been broken into or anything. The police station is right down the street. And we, so to speak, the junkies, people as they call them, they look out for you. The rent is $8.75 a month. I never want to go back to that life where I have to be sleeping in those streets or sleeping in the airport when rain fall and stuff like that, you know what I mean? So I make certain that I take care of my stuff. I know it's opportunity because I'm still planning to go back to school to do some computer training. And once I finish that, then I think I'm going to step out from the job I'm doing. Age is a number. You can be 100 years of age, and if you feel you have the capacity to do something, then you can do it. The sky is the limit for each and every one of us. So I always put God in front of my life because, you know, with him, without him, we are nothing. I mean, people say, oh, God don't exist, but I know he exists for me. With the things that I went through, I know he exists for me. I'm 50 years of age now. And if he spare my life to work the next 10 years, I could achieve a lot of stuff within the next 10 years.
Since we spoke, Sandra lost her job at the airport. She claims she was fired for going on strike over pay and working conditions. The company she worked for told the Miami New Times the union complaints were inaccurate. She's still sharing the same apartment with her youngest son. She says her health has been okay, and she still plans to take those computer classes very soon. If you'd like to share your story of money and the price of life in South Florida, email us, sunshineeconomy@wlrnnews.org. That's sunshineeconomy@wlrnnews.org.